Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding removing ambiguities in graft law written by R.K. Raghavan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Plus this will also help you in your essay preparation. Plus this is very important for public administration optional students. Now what is the issue discussed in this editorial? What this editorial is about? This editorial is about a change that is required to be brought in because of the indecisiveness, because of the lack of proactiveness, because of the timidness that has set in the bureaucrats. The bureaucracy in India is not taking the decisions. It has become indecisive. There has been a lot of slackness in decision making in the quarters of bureaucracy. Now, why this is happening? What is the reason behind this indecisive attitude of the bureaucracy? India has seen any number of scams in the past years, and basically all these scams, they relate to the financial irregulation, they relate to the malfeasance, they relate to causing some monetary or pecuniary benefit to the other people. Now there is a provision in Prevention of Corruption Act 1988 under section 13 subsection 1 clause 3d. Now this is a provision because of which the bureaucrats, they really feel the fear to take the decisions. Now what does this provision of section 13 subsection 1 clause 3d says? It says that if the case of causing pecuniary benefit to some third party can be made against a bureaucrat and this decision is not in the interest of causing some public welfare or public benefit, then that particular bureaucrat will be liable to face the trial of the court. Now the entire bureaucracy class is facing up the heat of this clause. They fear that if they will be taking up a decision, then this clause will be put up against them by the Central Bureau of Investigation or by the police, because this section is actually very strict and there is very less to be proved against them as being wrong. Now, as being wrong here in the legal terminology means mens rea. Now, what is mens rea? Mens rea is nothing but a dishonest intent. It is a wrongful intent. Now, wrongful intent to cause pecuniary benefit to some other individual, institution or organization by the decision that one is taking. Now, in the cases of 2G scam, in the cases of coal scam, the financial decisions were taken by the bureaucrats, and those decisions, because of those decisions and because of this clause, this section 13.1 subclause 3d, they have been facing the trial in the court. It is because of this section the bureaucrats, they feel demoralized. It is because of this section the growth rate of India, it has come down. It is because of this the bureaucracy has become more bureaucratic. It has become more red tapist. The bureaucrat is not ready to flex his muscles. Now, what will be the repercussions when this change will be introduced? When this section 13, subsection 1, 3D will be revoked? What will be the repercussions? The bureaucrats, they will feel more free to take the decisions. They will feel the space. They will feel autonomous. They will feel less fragile. They will feel less fearful. But what will be the repercussions? This will open up the floodgate of conducting more corruption. This will open up a avenue of being more corrupt. It will remove the fear in the minds of the bureaucrats for not treading the wrong path. Now, as far as this section is concerned, section 13, subsection 1, 3D, it is acting as a lid on the mind, on the conscience of the bureaucrats not to go for corruption, not to take such decisions which are not in consonance for the development of the country, which are not in consonance for the welfare of the country. But the complete amendment that is done to this Prevention of Corruption Act 1988, the government of India, it has come out with other stricter provisions. Isko to light kar diya hai, isko remove kar diya, but along with that, in order to make this act potent to fight against the corruption, government of India has cleared by the cabinet certain amendments which will be done to Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. Now those corruptions, they relate to increasing the sentence rate. Those relate to conducting the trials at a faster pace. So this dilution will be taken care of by the other stricter provisions, and this dilution will help the bureaucrats to become more proactive, to become more decisive, because this is something that is really required for the country to progress, for the country to develop. We should not be making bureaucracy more bureaucratic. Though there is a need to remove this crony capitalism and collusive corruption, and this collusive corruption can be removed only if we will be able to put up a strong act which can fight against the corruption. It is not by making the bureaucrats fearful. It's by institutionalizing good criminal justice system we can enter the face of corruption free governance. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 8459400000, and this number remains the same for WhatsApp. And you can ask any of the query if you have with respect to the civil services preparation. You can also visit my website, that is eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com, in case you're interested in knowing about the classes that we are offering for the civil services preparation. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find this application from Google Play Store. This is for the Android users, and for the apps and on the App Store for the Apple users. And in case you've liked this video, please click on the like button and do share this video and do comment on this video. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.